there. I have been really, really in the dumps lately because of literally what happened recently. If you don't know, like, it's really, really private. But this is something that I want to share with you guys. Like, really, I'm gonna make a really, really positive video, you know, like after this, and then I'm gonna upload a story behind. But this is very special because, like, this is something I don't want to, like, literally stay out. But this is beautiful because this is a part of a project I'm making, and it really, 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 really is a bummer that we do have to cope with these current days. But without further ado, this is the Uncle Tommy Project. So literally, this is a Nan's Uncle Tommy Project movie I've been working on, but there's something I want to do with this one specifically that's going to intertwine other universes. I want multiple animes to participate in this here film, because you have to understand, really big portion of this comes from the inspiration I have from, like, other films in general. This is dedicated to one of my funniest uncles. I have three, and they were all fucking hilarious. And Lily, this is the youngest one of my three uncles. I'm the youngest one of my four brothers, and this is the uncle that I can relate to the most. Isn't that funny? So this is Uncle Tommy's Lily special for Nans. You see, this is all about the numbers game. If you guys want to know, in the description below, you get to watch the Valentine's Day special. So Lily, there was this thing about numbers in Lily. So it was crazy. So my mom comes from a different culture, and she's obsessed with West Side Story. And Lily, she's half black, half white, and some people might think she's Mexican first thing. Lily, so Uncle Tommy's the same way, Uncle Jay's the same way. So what they really are, they're half black and half white, but Lily, they have, you know, long hair that Lily's in, Lily, and it's crazy because what happened is this. So Lily, it's crazy as fuck because there's three of my uncles. It's funny ass Uncle Jay, who I talk about on the channel the most, Lily, one of the heavy hitters from my channel, Uncle Jay, Lily, up there with Mr. Pleasure in terms of comedy, Lily, and my Uncle David, who's the oldest. So it goes like this. It's Uncle David, my favorite, Uncle Sonny, aka Uncle Jay, and then there goes Uncle Tommy. This was crazy as fuck because Uncle Jay is already too hysterical enough, but Lily, and you already know how I feel about Uncle David, but when Uncle Tommy goes along, that shit is too fucking much. That shit. Oh my fucking god. There was this one time where fucking Uncle David was telling me and Jeremy a fucking story. My cousin Jeremy came over and Uncle David told us a story about my Uncle Jay and Lily. Uncle Tommy is like, he's like, Mama, do you know, like, the time when we were little kids and Tommy and Sonny came out with that fight? Like, literally, like, you know the time we're at the restaurant and Sonny and Tommy busted out with a karate fight? And the Raider is literally trying to hold in his laughter? Yeah, that was Uncle Tommy. Oh my fucking god, so he was the youngest one, the one who wore glasses. We're literally crazy as fuck. So Lily, the story went like this. He was the one that Lily, he was one of the ones with the most ambition. So it went like this. Uncle Jay was the one who succeeded the most, but Uncle David actually went a life that Lily, you understand that you don't really want to be famous. So it's Uncle David, like, could have achieved fame and more, but lived a life, and Lily decided to play his options out. So you know what I'm saying, like that, but Uncle Jay strived for fame, and Uncle Tommy Lily got into a whole lot of trouble. He was the biggest troublemaker over my three uncles, and that shit was the funniest shit. Because literally, it was horrible. You don't understand what his character was. Literally, Uncle Jay used to tell me some funny ass stories about him. He's like, oh, yo, mess with Tommy. He's always trying to sue. He's always trying to sue someone. So literally, fucking, I got caught up in some trouble, literally. And literally, I come to Uncle Jay, and he's like, literally, my mom's trying to say, stop lying, stop lying. And literally, fucking Uncle Jay busts out of nowhere. I'm like, you know what you are, Eric? You're a liar. There's a difference between a liar and a con man. A con man is somebody who just lies to get by. You're a real liar because you're actually believing this shit. And that, oh my god, Uncle Jay was fucking hilarious. And then I'm like, well, what about Uncle Tommy? He's like, oh, well, that's a professional liar. Oh!
He'll borrow something from you so long you think you owe him.
No, but truly, I have to do this because he comes from a generation where everything is the most brutal. That's the reason why I have to do this. It's not so much him as a person. It literally, it's defining my family as a whole, but literally, it is for him as a person, but you know, what I'm saying is what he represented, because what he was, he was there back when the Beastie Boys was popping. He trained with the Beastie Boys. Him, Sonny, and David all played with the Beastie Boys in Lily Freaking. They used to do a lot back in the day. Like when my uncle said he could slide on his heels, that wasn't a joke. They all went to the military together. My uncles were the fucking shit every time they came over. That shit was hella crazy. Like, so what happened was this, so Lily, it was fucking crazy. But you know, that fucking, I want to state, you know, the negative part. But you know, so the crazy thing about that was he had a son named TJ that literally had cancer that loved anime. And literally, there was this one conversation where literally freaking like, he was telling me about the future of Dragon Ball Z and Majin Buu. He's like, yeah, boo booing stuff up and stuff like that. Like literally freaking, and his son loved, I repeat, loved anime. TJ like actually reads manga. Literally, his son loved anime and literally, but it's a really, really tragic story. What happened to Uncle Tabo was literally freaking, you know, Uncle Jay makes a joke out of every fucking serious story, fucking, like, Lily. He talks about my Auntie Elsie and fucking shit like that. Because Auntie Elsie is, like, you know, she's a beautiful person, but, you know, freaking, like, I guess kids can call her ugly, but, you know, she's a really good person. Like I can't disrespect shit because she is Lily. She is such a beautiful, like, after image, like, Lily. What happens is, like, Lily, her personality and persona doesn't make you question her freaking, her beauty at that point, because see, her face has a lot of wrinkles because she's 10 years older than my Uncle Tommy, but my Uncle Tommy ended up marrying her because literally, my Uncle Jay made a fucking, a joke out of it. She's like, well, you see that? You know what, Uncle Tommy's always drunk because look at who he has to come home to fuck. Literally, that shit is hella funny. He's like, it looks like he's breaking down walls to fuck her. He literally, that shit was hella funny. But Lily, I appreciate that comedy, but in actuality, it's not that. It's the Uncle Tommy is a handsome man. You know, fucking like, no homosexuality involved. You're stupid if you ask that question. So anyway, figure what happened was this, like, he can get with any girl, basically. So, but he does that because he got tired of trying too hard to fit in. The Uncle Tommy was the biggest troublemaker, and that is why he comes from that generation. But that's why, Lily, that generation plays no games, man. I'm telling you, that, Lily, that's when the Beastie Boys, like, Lily, he, Lily, and everyone was from that generation where everything was hype. The Star Wars generation, when Star Wars first came out, I remember Auntie Lisa talking about the story about Lily where it first came out, how everyone was a nerd at the time. It didn't matter if you were doing this and that, if you banged colors and shit. Everybody was hyped for going to the fucking Star Wars movie. Like, the first, where it first came out, after reading the books too, fucking how it was hella hype. Like, my mom was always, we would spam that conversation when we were younger and stuff like that. And they were wondering why freaking the older version, like when, you know, Yoda is computer animated and shit like that. Like, they were talking about how it used to be. Like, Lily, that used to be a shit growing up. Lily, talking about how their generation, like, viewed entertainment. It was really, really, really hype back in the day, I'm telling you. I think, like, you know, freaking, some of my family members do too short, like, Lily, because it's California. So what happened is, like, my family comes from Chicago. So, like, that's why this channel is so ghetto. But that's why I have a really different insight. But the point of this video is that it's because they come from the NWA, the Coolie High generation, the Superfly generation. They all come from that. The over 50 people right now, like, Lily, they come from that really, really hard generation, Lily. This is how everything started. Like, you know that piece by piece thing that Naruto, like, Lily, where you fucking slap a nigga white when you block this hit and shit like that? You know, Lily, when you're squared up with somebody and you put one, two, like Samurai Jack, like, little, hold up, you may block this, but I'm gonna hit you with this. That shit all came from Uncle Jay's generation, you know, and that is why you have to respect, you know, that, you know, craft or something. That's something the new generation knows nothing about. That, Lily, oh my god. You know, that shit was insane. Yeah, that was back in the day when literally everything was fucking popping. That was back when freaking up and David, you know, was getting down. My Uncle David used to be, you know, a radio host. He, like, that shit was crazy as fuck. So they were all out there. You get what I'm saying? You know, Uncle Tommy got kicked out of school when he was in junior high. That shit was hella fucking funny. But you know, fucking, when they come over, they're hella funny and shit. You get what I'm saying? But the message to you nerds is, because Uncle Tommy took all those risks, is why he had so much character. And that is the thing you have to understand about life. Like, he went on so many adventures and stuff like that. That's why he's so fucking funny. But Lily, I can't save Uncle Tommy's, you know, real comedy into Lily, his own comedy. I'm talking about Lily. Fucking, I can't do that into a future video, into, you know, freaking, you know, I get, you know, it, like, better insurance, you know, on a certain situation, you know. I can't make this video until that happens, because really what this is a make a wish foundation for nerds, because there was something that happened, you know, in the past between me and Uncle Tommy, but we got over it really, really quickly because we literally got along so well when we were younger, but it was on a different principle. Like literally, I was really, really dealing with, you know, BS, because I just replaced, you know, Lisa with Karma, and then Uncle Jay tried to Tyler Perry me, which I'm also saving for that future video. So what happened is Uncle Jay tried to like Tyler Perry me after I replaced, a big girl with a good girl. It wasn't the fact that she was fine, it was the fact that she was a really nice person, and I felt like that was BS. And so what happened is, you know, I had a past confrontation, you know, it was 2 years ago, so it's really, really buried, but, you know, that's the reason why I can't, you know, freaking make Uncle Tommy's rule with heavy hitters until all this is said and done, because I understand that Lily freaking that is really not, you know, affordable right now, because of Lily, we're about to get non-animated, we're about to do this and that, we're gonna have a whole lot of other shit, so, you know, we don't have time for, you know, for conflicts. That's why, you know, I'm doing this, because he was one of my, you know, favorite uncles and shit like that. I loved all of them and shit, but you have to understand, like, Lily, this is Lily me, you know, trying to move on in life, and this is me literally freaking, this is why I'm giving the nerd, because this is what actually, you know, love is, and like, this is what actually, like, fucking truth is, this is like fucking, this is where you truly give credit where credit is due to a fullest form. It would be really the biggest crime in the world for me to have Uncle Jay, Uncle David, if not talk about Uncle Tommy, but I have to wait till the ghost is clear. So anyway, but let me get into the real, you know, nitty gritty about this video. This is the real, real, real truth about this video. You know why I made this? This video is based off the past MV that I just posted. Literally, the last AMV I just posted has a political statement that I have to get through to you people to let you guys understand that literally, Uncle Tommy will be fusing with Steve from American Dad for this non-special. This is the crazy. So what this is that this non-special is based off of old school. We're going all the way, all the way, all the way old school. So this non-special is based off a conversation I had with Uncle Tommy, my mom, Uncle Sonny, aka Uncle Jay, and then my grandma. We were talking about old school movies like, you know, West Side Story, you know, Casino. We were talking about this and that, so literally freaking, you know, they were talking about, yeah. So my mom told me, there was this game where literally, these guys all went to go get numbers, and literally, when they got numbers, literally, one guy got more numbers than the other guy, but this one guy only got one number, and like, literally, but his one number was worth more than all of theirs. That's a story my mom told me when I was young, and literally, what happened is, that is why I put the numbers version in nines. That is why I put the numbers game in the Valentine's Day special, to literally pay homage to Uncle Tommy's generation. That's why it was so old school. So this is Lily. So this one dance scene, Nons, what happens if we have a whole dance movie with Tanjiro being my freshman year replication? Oh, I'm sorry, replication. Okay, but anyway, bro. But like, anyway, bro. Like a nigga myself from Attack on Titan, Tanjiro is requested. Lily, I want Tanjiro to be tutting in this movie. I want to be Ryan Stein, Izuku Midoriya. I don't want you to sugarcoat shit. I want this to be a Shonen Jump dance special based off the Soul Leader dance, like Lily, and also based off of their brain song with Billy and Maddie. You see, here's what's going to happen. This is called Nons. But Brick House Bandit. Nons. Because Uncle Tommy, every time he would come over, we would play that classic song. Season Brick House. Yes, this is based off the old school Brick House. This is Uncle Tommy and Steve for American Dad. This is a Shonen Jump movie special nods. It's based off really the excitement that we all had back when Star Wars first came out for the older generation. There's gonna be nerds in there. There's gonna be a reference from Family Guy when Cleveland was imitating Michael Jackson. So this is the plot of really nods, Brick House Bandit. So this fusion character for Nons is Lily, is going to be like the main basis of what Lily, Uncle Tommy slash Thieves role. So his name is Stommy Thieves is Lily his name, and what he is he's basically Uncle Jay's role, what he plays today. Like Lily, what Uncle Jay's backstory was is Lily, he used to be a desperate man for the older generation. He wanted to be just like Ray Romano. Uncle Jay wanted to be just like the heavy hitters, like Lily. He wanted to be the best of his generation, but lately he was this try-hard kid. He was exactly what I was in high school, but 10 times worse, to a point where you get kicked out of school and shit, like literally. So that was crazy. So Uncle Jay was a try-hard, so what happened was he went to jail and shit, you know, really got moved from a farm, became you know, this and that, you know, where Apple is this. So literally, where Apple was, literally, like, where Apple was, all the people from his generation, when he got out of jail, so he tried playing chess, so he changed when the generation was good, so when everyone died, he became chess champion, and literally, he lived that shit to this day, like, literally, that shit got him cocky, that shit got him this and that, and literally, that was, literally, Uncle Jay's, you know, tragic past, and, like, literally, where Apple is just so, like, Stommy. Hey, it's gonna be the same way. What he is he's gonna convince everyone, like, to buy a Louis Ultimate. He's gonna convince everybody to go to this big event because literally, he's still pretending that he's young. But literally, even though he's the best amongst his generation, like, literally, if compared to everybody in his past, like, literally, he was nothing. So Stommy is really coming in. And the reason why I want to make this thing, what is this all about? This is a fundraiser for nerds. Yes, this is a really good part about my Make-A-Wish Foundation to make every nerd a better person, to make every nerd more considerate, to make every nerd more aware of their surroundings so we can go all out and, like, and you can really, you know, see things the way of your favorite mangaka. I can see things. You have to understand, man. Like, because the reason why I want other shonen characters in this is because this is a statement I have to make for, you know, not just America, but, you know, how much anime has influenced, like, Western culture. I want multiple, like, anime, you know, protagonists dancing in this film because, like, I'm going to get to the storyline later on. Like, there will be action. So, literally, the reason why I requested everything on this plate was because of this. Because, literally, Steve from American Dad, if you go watch my last AMV, you will be infuriated. Like, literally, absolutely atrocious. You don't understand. Do you know this AMV almost got me killed? This idea for Steve from American Dad and the AMV almost got me killed. You don't understand. This is an idea I had back in 8th grade. So I told my brother, like, really this. I'm like, I like Chingy Flying Molly, and he always criticized me for beats like that. And he's like, but there's nothing wrong with that beat, but there is if you're trying to be, like, a rugged hip-hop. That's a different form of hip-hop because Chingy gets spit. So anyway, yeah, I know a lot of our raps, so Chingy can spit, so don't diss that. So, like, my brother didn't doubt that. But literally, what happened was this. Like, literally, what happened was, I chose Stevie as Chingy, and, like, literally, my brother was all like, man, this isn't working. You know he's lame in the show, and you're trying to make him look good in this A&B. It's not working, Gary. So, like, literally, he did that, literally, all the way back in 8th grade, and that reverse psychology means I'm going to end your life. That is literally... Don't think that's not a death threat, because that reverse psychology is literally flipping the whole world upside down. There's a different form of reverse psychology where they literally, they don't freaking mask it as well. But it's really, really believable because, oh, he's lame and he's trying to lose his virginity. I'm trying to make him look like a rapper in the AMV. That's really, really, really heavy gaslighting. You gotta understand, when you make that many key points, like, literally freaking... Like, literally, that's the difference between a fucking nerd and a fucking normal person, because a nerd will make a fucking comparison based off, like, two things. It has to be, like, three or four things or more. I've done the research. I know the difference between symbolism and, you know, literally, just making bullshit connections. They're really two big different things. So, literally, that was a super close one. That I had to make sure I had, like, literally, freaking, like, you know, protection before I did that shit. Like, literally, you have to understand. Literally, you know what my brother said to that? You know what people mean by that? When I pick characters in the air, bro, like Jalal, fucking Hidon, you know what they try to say? They're trying to say, yo, Riz, you can't be sticking your dick out in public. That's all they're trying to say. But they mask it saying that, yo, fucking, you think the drip is cool, but the drip isn't everything, man. Like, that is a weenie's way of viewing life. Because what they're coming at is they're trying to say that I'm the pretty boy. I'm like, no, I'm fucking Freezer. There's a big-ass fucking difference, you know? They're like, Lily, that is Lily. Because there's this character and the devil is a part-time. His name is Lucifer. He wears all purple, and he literally has a really good bang. And Lily, freaking, he wears purple, like, really, a white shirt with purple sleeves, really, fucking... But Lily, a really hard ass bang with one eye sticking out. Lily, a clean ass fucking character, man. Like, Lily, you can't hang on him. But Lily, the air realm views me as him. But they make me think that, like, Lily, they try to, like, do different shit. Like, that's how people view me. And so, Lily, when I put Steve in that AMV, and I'm like, that's why people don't like me. That's why people are so envious. That's why people do everything to say that I'm not what the fuck I say I am. Like, oh, the way we're viewing it are two different things. No, they're fucking not. Like, Lily, you have to understand that. Lily, But, you know, that's also a problem in America. Do you know, I'm going to make a future video. You know, that's the reason why Soul Eater wasn't a long-going anime. It had all the materials to be a big green anime, but the reason why was because they kept complaining because Death the Kid was shit on Naruto. Because, really, all the drip, that drip where it lasted for 100 episodes. But no, we have this thing in America where it says that's too good to be true is probably it. They say the same thing about my girls. Oh, there's no such thing as a hot, intelligent girl. They get everything through their fucking pussy pass. Literally, all their college community girls. I'm like, oh, college is fucking easy because it's just repetition. All you have to do is study. It's like that. Guys are better at other shit. Like, literally, it's not. The excuses guys make, it's not. That's a stereotype in America. This is the movie. It's specifically to break that stereotype in America. There are beautiful, strong people out there. Like, literally, some of the most strongest people are beautiful, you know. There's a lot, you know, that you have to carry. You have to understand that. And, like, literally, judging a book by its cover is really, really hard. But when they're forcing a stereotype on you, that's even worse. That's literally been a really bad, that's a MGTOW effect. If you don't know what MGTOW is, go look up MGTOW on YouTube. M-G-T-O-W. MGTOW. MGTOW is about guys who want to, like, stop working because they've already worked hard. They already know how females work. They don't want to literally have a biased environment that's particularly in favor of a woman. And, like, literally, that, this is a Make-A-Wish foundation for all this shit, like, literally. And what's going on is like this, like, it is a stereotype. Like, they train girls in society to be, you know, stereotypical. But if they're raised by a good family, that's a different story. We have to understand that. But this is crazy. So this is the break the stereotype. Like, oh, no, you can't put Steve in a rap AMV. It's too good to be true. He's too lame in the show. This and that. He is the best character in the show, and you know it. Just stop, man. Like, literally, fucking the devil told me himself. That's why I hate you. Like, literally, no, seriously, the devil has told me this himself. Like, literally, this is why people don't like you. This is that. Like, literally, the devil literally has done that. Literally. And what they mean by that is too good to be true. Me making Steve a rapper in an AMV is really, this is the shit that Stone is afraid to say out loud. And that's the whole reason why this nigga is fucking stupid. That's the whole reason why this whole fucking, you know, the majority of the people, you know, fucking society are fucking stupid. Because they're afraid to admit that shit. They're keep on trying to do, you know how being popular works? It's literally doing what my brother did right then and there with Steve, really. Having an amazing fucking concept. An amazing fucking concept. And literally just shitting on it and, like, literally saying that it's not what you think it is. And what that is that's a pretty word for it. What they do is they bring a prison mentality to a guy who looks good. And they try to say, oh, you're a pretty boy. You have to be masculine to, like, in order to get girls. They did a whole lot to that. There was this time when I was a senior in high school where I threw a temper tantrum in front of the whole school because I didn't want to go to Six Flags because it wasn't like Waterworld in 8th grade. Yeah, I did that. I did that a lot, but guess what happened? I ended up fucking, literally, half those girls who saw me on the fucking bus throwing a temper tantrum, yelling at my mom and shit, literally, through the fucking phone, like, literally, that's a brat, no shit. But you know why? Because I was scared to ride the roller coaster. I really was. There's not much to do in Six Flags besides roller coasters. And that shit was on purpose. When I figured out that there was a gang activity that was revolving around that school and they tried to make me look like a little kid, that shit all escalated. And, like, literally, you know what the devil told me right then there in my head? He's like, stop relying on things being like they are in 8th graders. And that is why you don't like Steve. So Anthony is also going to star in this Don's movie. And he's going to be the one who breaks light of the situation. He's the one who's going to be fun done right. So he's going to be basically like Harry Potter. I think Harry Potter and Anthony subdues for this one. But it's not gonna be in the form of like him nor magic, but fucking, I think he might, you know, fucking actually fucking be useful. I just thought of that just now. Brain blast, you know. So if you wanna get my level of writing, you know, you gotta go on the time chamber. So literally freaking what's going on is this, so like Anthony and freaking Harry Potter are fusing for this movie and literally freaking they have a statement to be made. It's kind of like Mr. Enter. Mr. Enter's probably going to enter this too. You know how I love Mr. Enter. I'm going to make Mr. Enter a detective and he's going to team up for Anthony. So like literally they're going to team up for Anthony and they're going to say Thomas isn't wrong, but literally like freaking, you know what I'm saying? Like freaking Stommy isn't wrong. Stommy is not wrong. But at the same time, there's something evil going on there that's out of his control because Thomas is a little kid. Like, Stommy literally is, like, literally in his head. Like, literally, he's a grown-ass adult, but he acts like a little kid, still getting drunk, still pretending that, like, he's in his early 20s and shit. But literally, he's really, really up there in terms of age. But he convinces Gabaya and everybody to come, and literally what happens is, so I'm imagining Tavro going down at this brick house party, literally, where Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo is playing. So you know what Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo is based off? Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo is based off that song Poison from Belle Bib DeVoe. So Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo will be performing and Stommy is telling everybody about it. I want Tanjiro to be telling about Izuku to be popping the lock and they gotta be dancing alongside Gabaya. So I think better maybe send this one out. I have no idea. That's up to the studio, Lily. That is up to Lily Better. That's up to Lily freaking. That is up to the Better team. Yeah, for sure, for sure. So, you know, anyway, freaking, this idea was based off the Blob in Billy and Mandy. the Brain song. So the Brain and Billy and Mandy will be breaking the brick house for the antagonist for this movie. So the Brain is for Billy and Mandy. So there's going to be a secret mystery there, and there's going to be a mystery character named Billy Jackson, based off the Michael Jackson outfit that Billy wore during the Brain song. So basically, freaking, there's going to be Billy Jackson there. He's like, basically, there's going to be a Billy Jean mystery. And it's like, Nellie Jean is like, Lily freaking. So what's happening is Nellie Jean was like, there's this character in Bleach called Nell. And like, what's going to happen is like, Lily, there's a character in My Hero Academia that's kind of epic for shattering Timdachi. So like, Lily, what happened is there's a magician in My Hero Academia that can put shit in a bowl. So there's another world where like, Lily freaking, Billy Jackson is keeping Nellie Jean in a little like tiny ball, like Lily, a magical ball that Lily that's like can be in the size of your palm. Like, you know those little bouncy balls, like Lily, you get out the like the slot machine, like that's the little ball, magic ball that Billy Jackson has. He's trying to capture like Nellie Jean and shit like that, but he can't do it until like the brain monster from Billy and Mandy does this certain thing to this many people. So Stommy has no idea that they're gonna break the brick house. And so Gabaya and everyone is up to Lily, the shonen protagonist of Shonen Jump. This is Lily. Soon up from Hitman Reborn. Oh, I hope he's in there. Oh, but there hasn't been a dub for Reborn, so that is highly most unlikely. But Lily, oh my god, Tanjiro is a really, really, really better possibility, though. Tanjiro, Asta, yes, I want all of them to be in there. Izuku are all gonna fight alongside with Gabaya and his friends. Lily, this is what I want. So the only characters that like I'm requesting so far are the ones that I'm for sure like is a heavy possibility, like Deku, Asta, and you know, Tanjiro, the new generation that's based off your boy and shit. That is literally what I want to see in there. So Lily, I don't want sugarcoat shit. I want everything to be there. I want Stylus to play a big role. Lily, so he's gonna have a Master Roshi exterior because Uncle Tommy is like preferred too. There's a story that my Uncle Jay tried to tell me, like, you know, we were on the train and this lady asked to sit like Lily somewhere. And he's like, she's like, can I sit there? Uncle Tommy sat there, the place where she was about to sit, and he was covering his face. He's like, oh, go ahead. This is all for Uncle Tommy and his son who loves anime. So like Lily, this is all for TJ, my cousin TJ, who told me about his death though. He was talking to my older brother about it too. Like Lily, oh my god. So this is Lily, the really a big, big, big Make a Wish Foundation for nerds, a really, really big reference to my family, a really, really big reference to life, you know, whoever, you know, trying to mix with Sans Jimmo and like Lily on Instagram or anything, like try to contact Sans Jimmo if you like, if you want any specific Nas character. I only have the main cast right now in my head. Zaf, most definitely. Zaf wearing red, a red collar, you know, freaking getting down like the older generation, you know, freaking like a Rum DNC type movie, you know, I'm talking about, you know, all that other shit. So that's who I'm requesting so far. So Lily, if you want to know like anything about Nas, talk to Sans Jimmo or Christopher Sabat, because they're the ones who are helping me with this project. So like Lily, if you want any help, you have to go to them. So like Lily, but if you want like characters, like, you know, like if you want Bree in there and stuff like that, like that's not what I originally planned, but if you want that, they're the ones who can make it happen. So like Lily, this is Blue Creeks, and I'm glad that you stayed around. And yes, this is another beat I made for this specialty. And I, Lily, but another reason why I made this is because this is like the Lemur and Nas, the other Nas wrestlers will really, really be on delay. And the reason why this is like most likely to be more front facing is because there's a big, big problem with the Valentine's Day special, you know, with the behind the scenes and stuff. I can't personally state, but at the same time, like, you know, this would be better for like everyone. It's the topic. And you know, nerds are really, really having a tug of war, you know, with My Hero Academia, obviously epic for centering my anime, you know, over and over and over again. Like, I'm gonna make a video about that too, you know, freaking with My Hero Academia over and over and over again. But you know, fucking freaking Bakugo and Todoroki would be cool for this movie. And you know, but basically, you know, what I'm trying to say is this, you know, Finro from Black Clover also be fucking cool, you know, freaking backing on the chicks with Stommy, Uncle Stommy and Finro, that would be cool. But you know, what I'm really trying to get at is the reason why I make that, so people can understand that there's more to life than just beauty and like in this. Now like, a lot of people like don't understand like how hard it is, you know, to be beautiful. Like coping with that beautiful method is already a responsibility. So this is a really big, you know, representation that, you know, freaking, this is really, really some bad shit, you know, freaking like Lily, this is like telling you some real shit. Like this is a really, really a big message. There's a message behind that, and this is the real reason why this is crazy as fuck. So without further ado, this is the plot, this is the idea, and this is the execution of, you know, freaking, this is Lily where I want to be, like Lily freaking, this is, you know, Nas, Brick House Bandit.
yeah. I've seen a lot of girls, yeah. But you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. You done rolled through some hoods, yeah. And some girls that look good, yeah. But you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. You done partied in some clubs, and some girls show you love, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. Like me, baby.
Let's go.
But you never
check
had a girl
out.
Look
hey,
so look. Fly like
hey,
me.
Now I done been around the world, thought I seen it all. Color, earth, shape, what I need and all. Switch like seasons, winter, summer, spring and fall. In backseat of my Jeep on chrome feet and all. On the hunt for these girls was like my day to day. Get them alone, I jump them and then fade away. I give it good so some of them won't stay away. They try to lock me up but I break away. Until the day I lay my eyes on the princess. And you can tell she was a dime from a distance. It took a minute to come to my senses. She's the perfect match, just God is my witness. Now for the first time I've opened my eyes, put my glass in the air, now I'm toasting the sky. Feels like I'm in heaven and I'm hoping to fly. Baby girl, come along for the ride, you know why, cause I've
been around the world and seen a lot of girls, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. Now you done rolled through some hoods and some girls that look good, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. You done partied in some clubs and some girls show you love, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. Like me, baby, but yeah. You never had a girl look yeah. So yeah. Fly yeah. Like me.
Now I ain't never had a girl that was so fly. Other guys come around, you acting so shy. You got them shaking in their boots, and I know why. Cause they can't handle the truth, and that's no lie. As for me, I'm the one that you've been dreaming on. And when you saw me, I'm the one that you was scheming on. And when you need it, I'm the shoulder you'll be leaning on. Take off that Gucci and keep the Vicky secrets on. Let's take a flight, cause the world is our playground. And buy houses from the Loop to the A-Town. And silk sheets so it's soft when you lay down. Ching-a-ling, yeah, I get down and stay down. There's no one better, baby girl, you's a blessing. You got me headed in a positive direction. You got my vote when you re-up for election. Cause all I wanna do is give you love and affection.
I've been around the world and seen a lot of girls, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. You done rolled through some hoods and some girls that look good, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. You done partied in some clubs and some girls show you love, but you ain't never seen a girl look so fly. Girl.